हरिओम, वेलकम यू ऑल टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ डेटा माइनिंग एंड डेटा वेयर हाउसिंग कोर्स. सो वी आर करंटली टॉकिंग अबाउट द डिसीशन ट्रीज विच आर यूज इन द क्लासिफिकेशन स्कीम. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड वॉट इज मशीन लर्निंग, वॉट डू यू मीन बाय सुपरवाइज्ड एंड अनसुपरवाइज्ड लर्निंग. देन classification is one of the supervised learning. So we discussed what is classification and what are the two important steps of classification process in our previous video. All these things we have already discussed. And in the next video we have talked about the decision tree. What do you mean by a decision tree? Then we also talked about what do you mean by training set and test set. Then we have seen the three different attributes that are used for implementing the decision tree: the numerical attribute, categorical attribute, and class labels. And I gave you the definition of decision tree like this, and I asked you to correct the errors also. So this is the corrected one. So in our previous video we had this leaf node, internal and branch node marked in a wrong way, so I have corrected it. So those who have gone through the previous video, please correct your notes. This is the correct decision tree for the given data. And this is another example of a decision tree, and we have seen what is a root node, what do you mean by a branch, what do you mean by internal node, what do you mean by leaf node, etc. Then we also talked about what do you mean by a path in your decision tree. The path is used to define a classification rule of the decision tree. And then we have seen what do you mean by a splitting attribute and what do you mean by a splitting criteria. Today in this video we are going to talk about how the decision tree is to be constructed. So this is an example of the decision tree. You can have a decision tree like this, where this is the root node, these are the internal nodes, these are the branches, and these are the leaf nodes. The same way here, this is the root node, which is again having a partition, and these are the branches, and again these are the internal nodes, and these are the leaf nodes. So this is an example which we have already discussed in our previous videos also. And now we are going to see how this decision tree can be constructed. We know that decision tree is the most powerful and popular tool for classification and prediction. The decision tree construction methods are based on the principle of recursively partitioning the data set till homogeneity is achieved. So this is the basic principle used for constructing the decision tree. So what we are going to do here, the given data set will be partitioned. So generally the data set which is used for constructing the decision tree will be the training data. So the training data set will be partitioned until homogeneity is achieved. What do you mean by homogeneity? When you have created a partition, so the set of records that are coming in this particular partition will have all the class labels with value no. The set of records which are coming in this particular partition will have the class labels, all the records will have the class label as yes. Or if you take this decision tree, the set of records which are coming in this particular partition, so you will partition the data below age 30 will come in this partition, above 30 will come into this partition. Again, in the above 30, you are going to check whether they are doing exercise in the morning. So those who are doing exercise in the morning will come in this partition. those who are not doing exercise in the morning will come in this particular partition. So obviously you will have your set of records here, you will have set of records here. Okay, now the set of records that are coming in this particular partition will have the class label as unfit. That means all the records in this partition will have the class label as unfit. That is what you mean by homogeneity. So until homogeneity, so ibda illa ella records num unfit aayirkanam class label, ibda illa ella records num fit aayirkanam class label, ibda illa ella records num class label will be fit, ibda illa ella records num class label will be unfit. So if you have this homogeneity, ഇതിനെയാണ് നമ്മൾ ഹോമോജിനിറ്റി പറയുന്നത്. ബിക്കോസ് ഇവിടെയുള്ള എല്ലാ റെക്കോർഡ്സിനും ഒരേ ക്ലാസ് ലേബിളാണ് ഉണ്ടാവുന്നത്. സോ ഹോമോജിനിറ്റി മീൻസ് ദി സെറ്റ് ഓഫ് റെക്കോർഡ്സ് ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് പർട്ടിക്കുലർ പാർട്ടീഷൻ വിൽ ഹാവ് സെയിം ക്ലാസ് ലേബിൾ. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് വാട്ട് യു കോൾ എസ് ഹോമോജിനിറ്റി. സോ അൺടിൽ ഹോമോജിനിറ്റി ഈസ് അച്ചീവ്ഡ് ഇൻ ഓൾ ദി പാർട്ടീഷൻസ് വി ആർ ഗോയിങ് ടു ഡു റിക്കേഴ്സീവ്ലി പാർട്ടീഷനിങ് ദി ഡേറ്റാ സെറ്റ്. സോ for which decision tree is constructed by splitting the source data set, which will be your training data, into subsets based on the attribute value. So what we are going to do, based on one attribute value we will start splitting the data set into subsets. This is what you call as partitioning. So this process will be repeated on each derived subset also in a recursive manner called recursive partitioning. Ille so you will be splitting on age, so you will get partition 1 here, partition 2 here, partition 3 here. Okay, again this partition 2 will be recursively split based on student attribute. So this process is repeated on each derived subset. Derived subset is the partition, right, in a recursive manner called recursive partitioning. And this recursion will be stopped when the subset at a node all has the same value of the target variable. So all the no subsets or all the records are having the same class label here, then we can stop the recursion. Or when splitting no longer adds a value to the prediction. So when you are going to split, it is not going to give you new partitions or new predictions, then you can stop the recursion. So decision tree will be constructed by splitting. So this is the first step. After splitting, you are going to recursively partition the derived subsets also. Then the recursion will be stopped when the subset, all the records in the subset has same value, or the splitting is not going to give you any new value for the prediction. If so, let us have the construction of the decision tree with three different phases. One is the construction phase, pruning phase, and processing the pruned tree. These are the three phases of constructing the decision tree. Let us see what is construction phase. So construction phase is the one which is going to construct the decision tree. So the base decision tree will be constructed using this phase. We are going to initial decision tree will be constructed based on the training data set, and this training data set will be partitioned into two or more subsets, right? So if I take here, this is partitioned into two subsets, right? Whereas if I take this example, this is partitioned into three subsets. So that is why we say partitioning the training set into two or more subsets. How you are going to partition? By using a splitting criteria on a particular attribute. So this is the point which is to be noted, very important one. What is the splitting criteria and what is the splitting attribute you are going to use for partitioning the data? And this process of partitioning will be repeated until a stopping criteria. Generally the stopping criteria will be till all the records in the partition belong to the same class, which you call as the homogeneity. Okay, so the very important point here in the construction phases, which splitting criteria and which splitting attribute you are going to take for partitioning the training set, right? So we'll be discussing how to decide which is the best splitting criteria and how to decide best splitting attribute in the upcoming videos. Okay, so this is how we will be constructing the decision tree. So you have to decide whether you want to split. Suppose if you have a set of students, the one of the attributes of the student may be gender of the student. Another attribute of the student records may be in which particular standard he is studying. So when you are going to split the set of records, the training data, you may be starting with splitting the data based on gender, or you may be splitting the records based on the standard they are studying. So whether you have to choose the gender as the first attribute for splitting, or whether you have to choose the standard as the best attribute for splitting, will be decided based on a particular measure, which we will be discussing later. So this is what it says: splitting criteria on a particular attribute, right? Which attribute and which criteria, that has to be decided. So this is one of the very important point to be noted while constructing the decision tree. So this process will be repeated again and again. Now, the second phase is the pruning phase. Whatever tree we are going to construct in the previous phase, it may not result in the best possible set of classification rules. So that may not give you. Suppose, say for example, you are going to construct your decision tree using this partitioning process, and you have used some splitting criteria and splitting attribute, but that may not give you the best possible set of classification rules. Why? Because of a problem called overfitting problem, right? So since your training data may not give the correct decision tree, or because of this overfitting problem, we go into the pruning phase, right? So the pruning phase is introduced to resolve the overfitting problem. So what the pruning phase will do? This phase will remove some of the lower branches and nodes to improve the performance of the decision tree. Okay, so if this is the case, we have to understand what is pruning and we have to understand what is overfitting problem, right? So the second phase, what it is going to do? It is going to do the pruning process. Why it is doing the pruning process? Because the decision tree may have overfitting problem. If so, we have to understand what is pruning and what is overfitting. So pruning is nothing but, pruning is the process of reducing the size of the tree. How we are going to reduce the size of the tree? By turning some branch nodes into leaf nodes and removing the leaf nodes under the original branch. So some of the branch nodes will be converted into leaf nodes, and the leaf nodes will be removed from that particular branch. This is how the pruning process will be done. I'll show you an example here. So this is the unpruned decision tree and this is a pruned decision tree. And you can observe here in the pruning process, this complete branch is removed and the leaf node has been replaced for the branch. What it says? Turning some branch nodes into leaf nodes. So this branch nodes will be turned into a leaf node. Okay. Then removing the leaf nodes under the original branch. So under the original branch, you have lots of leaf nodes. All these leaf nodes are removed, and the entire branch is now represented as a leaf node. This is what you mean by pruning process. Again, this is another example. You have all these nodes here. So instead of having this age branch, this branch is completely removed here, and instead of this branch there is only one leaf node represented here. So this is the original tree and this is the pruned tree. Okay, so pruning is nothing but reducing the size of the tree. How we are going to reduce the size? By turning some branch nodes into leaf nodes and removing the leaf nodes under the original branch. So that is what is specified here. In the pruning phase, the phase will remove some of the lower branches and nodes to improve its performance. Okay. Now, pruning is very useful because classification trees may fit the training data well but may perform a poor job of classifying new values. Why? When we are going to use this pruning? Because the classification trees, the decision tree, will give you the correct result for the training data, but that may not give the correct classification rules for the new values in the data set. This is when we are going to use the pruning process. So generally, the simpler tree often avoids the overfitting problem. So if you have this problem, right, classification tree is correctly fitting into the training data but it is not correctly fitting into the new values, then this problem is what we call as overfitting problem. So the overfitting problem can be avoided by simpler trees. How do you get the simpler trees? By the pruning process. Okay, so let us see what is overfitting problem now. So overfitting problem, already we have seen the overfitting problem is this one. Classification tree fit the training data well but it performs a poor job of classifying for the new values. So let us see the proper definition of overfitting. This is the definition of overfitting. A decision tree T is said to overfit the training data if there exists other tree called as T dash, which is a simplification of T, right? So I have a decision tree T and this is said to overfit the training data when if there exists other tree T dash, which is a simplification of T. Okay, so ee decision tree T ne eppozhaanu overfitting problem undu nu paraya, the condition is there is another T dash. This T dash is a simplification of T such that the condition is the error generated by the decision tree T is lesser than the error generated by T dash over the training data, but the error generated by T dash is lesser over the error generated by the tree T for the entire data set. Right? This is what you call as overfitting problem. I repeat, a decision tree is said to overfit the training data when if there exists another tree T dash, which is a simplification of T, such that it satisfies these two conditions. What are the two conditions? Error of T must be lesser than error of T dash over the training data, but error of T dash is lesser than error of T over the entire data set. So T in oru tree, decision tree T inde, decision tree T dash inde. T dash is simplification of T and the condition here is error of T less than error of T dash over the training data, but error of T dash is lesser than error of T over the entire data set. So the same overfitting is defined like this also. We can define the overfitting problem like this also. Consider the error of hypothesis H. Right, ഇവിടെ hypothesis H എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് നമ്മളുടെ decision tree T ആണ്. Okay, hypothesis H, we let the error on the training data. Training data al verna error na we denote it like this, error of training data of H, and error over the entire distribution D of data is called as error of D of H. Then a hypothesis H overfits the training data if there is an alternative hypothesis H dash such that error on the training data for the hypothesis H is lesser than error on the training data with on the hypothesis H dash. The same, but the error on the entire distribution of data for hypothesis H dash is lesser than the error on the entire distribution of data for the hypothesis H. Right? So the only difference here is, here we talk in terms of decision tree, whereas here we talk in terms of hypothesis, error of hypothesis H. Right? So this is the definition of overfitting. Let us see an example, then it will be more clear for you. Let us take this example, right? Why we take this example is the overfitting problem occurs due to the noise in the data. Whenever you have some missing values, erroneous values in the data set, obviously overfitting problem may arise. Now, this is an example training set for classifying the mammals. And these asterisks, right, these are the two data, these are the noise data, right. It says bat is a warm-blooded animal and it gives birth, right, and it is not a four-legged animal and it hibernates also, and the class label says no, because we know that bat is a mammal, but here it says bat is not a mammal, which is an erroneous data. The same way, whale is also a mammal, but here in this record, it says whale is not a mammal. So these are the two noisy data we have in this particular training set. Okay, so this is the training set we are going to give to construct the tree, decision tree. So using that training data, this will be the decision tree constructed. So it goes with body temperature. If it is warm-blooded, then it checks whether it gives birth. If it gives birth, it checks whether it is four-legged. If yes, it says it is a mammal. So if it is not four-legged, it says it is non-mammal. See, actually, the machine is reading the data from this training set, and whatever information it is retrieving from this training set, based on that, it will construct the tree. Okay. So, we know that maybe a two-legged animal or animal without legs may also be called as a mammal. Say, for example, whale is not having any leg. That is a mammal actually. But in the training data, it is not given so. So, that is why when the decision tree is constructed by the machine learning algorithm, it will be constructing the decision tree like this. Okay. Now, if you see the training set, in the training set, the model 1 misclassifies human and dolphin as non-mammals. Why? Because this is the test data. This is the test data I am going to give. This is the test data I want to give. Now, in the test data, actually human is classified as a mammal, okay? Then dolphin is also classified as a mammal. But according to this decision tree, it will first check for human whether the body temperature is warm-blooded. Yes, body temperature is warm-blooded, okay. Next, it will take the gives birth attribute. Gives birth attribute is also yes. Okay. And human will be checked whether it is four-legged. Obviously no. Human is not a four-legged animal. So it will go to this particular path. But here it says it is non-mammal, and you check here in the test data, the class label says yes. So that means it is this decision tree is going to give you an error. Or when it is taking dolphin again, dolphin is a warm-blooded, so it is warm-blooded, it goes here and it will check whether it gives birth. Yes, dolphin also gives birth there, but it will check whether it is four-legged. Dolphin is not four-legged, so it comes here again. If you see, it gives you the result saying non-mammal, whereas the test data says dolphin is a mammal. So obviously for human and dolphin it is going to give you an erroneous value. So error of this tree will be, error of this tree will be calculated for the training set with this test data. Okay, now what we are going to do, using the pruning process, this particular decision tree is pruned like this. This decision tree is pruned like this. How? So once you check the body temperature and if you see whether it is giving birth, then immediately I can declare it is a mammal. I need not check whether it is a four-legged or two-legged or the legless animal, right? So I can prune this particular branch. I can prune this particular branch and I am going to denote it with the leaf node mammal. Now using this model, if you test, it goes with this particular value. It will be checking the human body temperature is warm-blooded. Human body temperature is warm-blooded. And it gives birth. Yes, gives birth is yes. Then immediately I can declare it is a mammal. Then it is going to give you the errorless classification for human. The same way for dolphin also, it is going to check the body temperature. Dolphin body temperature is warm-blooded, so it comes here. And a dolphin gives birth, so the value is yes. So obviously it will say the dolphin is also a mammal. So just by pruning this particular branch, the error value is reduced for the entire data distribution, whereas the unpruned tree gives the correct or errorless value for this training data, but the pruned tree is giving you the errorless classification or lesser error classification for the entire data set. This is what you call as overfitting. So this is T, decision tree T, and this is decision tree T dash. This is decision tree T and this is decision tree T dash. So decision tree T is giving lesser error comparing to T dash for the training data, whereas decision tree T dash is giving lesser error than the decision tree T for the entire data set. So this kind of overfitting may arise due to the noise in the training data, due to the error in the training data. So in the training data, if you have any invalid values or erroneous values, obviously it will result in the overfitting problem. So what we are going to do is, to avoid this overfitting problem, we can go for the pruning process. So tree pruning is performed in order to remove anomalies in the training data due to noise or outliers. The pruned trees are smaller and less complex, and the tree pruning approaches can be done with pre-pruning or post-pruning. So pre-pruning means the tree is pruned by halting its construction early. So you stop the decision tree construction and you start pruning the tree. Post-pruning is the approach, this particular approach removes a subtree from a fully grown tree. So we generally do, in this case, we are doing the post pruning process. We construct the entire decision tree, then we go for the removing the subtree. So we removed this particular subtree. So that is post pruning. What you can do, you can start constructing the tree. Suppose, say for example, you can have two or three levels of the tree, then immediately you can go for pruning the decision tree. Then you can go for constructing the decision tree again. So that is what we call as pre-pruning approach. So either approach you can use for overcoming the overfitting problem in the decision tree construction. So the third phase is processing the prune tree. So to improve the understandability, we are going to process the prune tree. So you just rearrange everything and denote everything in the decision tree so that the understandability can be improved in the pruned tree. So these are the three phases for the construction of the decision tree. Right? So the very important point to be noted here is in the construction, the splitting criteria and splitting attribute is to be decided. Then we are going to repeat the process of partitioning until homogeneity is achieved. Whereas in the pruning phase, the overfitting problem is to be studied, and if there is a overfitting problem, the tree must be pruned. When we will get the overfitting problem? If you have an erroneous or noisy data in the training set, then overfitting problem will arise. So once the tree is pruned, we can go for process the pruned tree. What we are going to do? We are going to simply improve the understandability of the pruned tree. So this is how the decision tree will be constructed. Now let us see what are the issues faced by the decision tree algorithms while constructing the decision tree. These are the challenges we can say, or these are the issues faced by the decision tree. So the first very important issue is ordering of splitting attribute. That is, in the order in which the attributes are to be chosen is very important. As I told you, the attributes must be ranked based on some attribute selection measure. So these are the measures we are going to use. We will be discussing later what do you mean by entropy value, Gini value, information gain value, and how these values are used for selecting the best splitting attribute. We will be discussing later. So what we have to understand here, the order of splitting attribute is very important. The order can be calculated by using some kind of measures, and these measures will be used to choose the best splitting attribute. For example, if you have your data, whether you want to split on the class, whether you want to split on the performance in the class, right? So the performance in the class is denoted as above average or below average. Whether we have to start with splitting the data based on the performance, or whether we have to start with splitting the data based on whether 10th standard or 11th standard. So this will be decided. So which attribute used to be chosen first, right? So this will be decided based on the selection measure, entropy, Gini index and information gain values. So this is one of the issues faced in the decision tree algorithm. Now the second issue is choosing the splitting attribute, splitting criteria, best splitting criteria. Here ordering, and here choosing the splitting attribute and the criteria. So best splitting criteria is when all the tuples in the partition belong to the same class, right? So this way all the records in that particular partition is having same class, then we can say that is the best splitting criteria of that particular attribute. So some attributes are better than the other, So choice of the attribute should be such that it minimizes the expected number of tests needed to classify a given tuple and guarantees a simple tree structure. Say for example, if you have chosen average is the splitting attribute, now the next question is whether this attribute criteria can be lesser than 4.7 or equal to 4.7 or greater than or equal to 4.7. What condition you are going to use for splitting, that has to be decided. As I told you, when you are going to have the splitting, you can have, we have seen, I'll take that figure, this one, right? So whether you are going to have this age split into young, middle-aged, senior, or you are going to have the condition as young and not young. So two types of criteria I can take for this particular attribute. Suppose if you have chosen age is the best splitting attribute, the next question is what criteria you are going to take. Now when you take age, you can have different criteria. First criteria can be age is equal to young, age is equal to middle aged, age is equal to senior. So by the time I will have three different branches. Or you can have whether age is equal to young or not. So that means you will have only two branches. Age is equal to young, and all these things will be put in another branch, age is not equal to young. So like that, the criteria should also be decided here when you are going to construct the decision tree. Not only ordering the attribute, apart from that, criteria should also be decided. So choice of the attribute and the criteria should be such that it minimizes the expected number of tests needed to classify the tuple and guarantee a simple tree structure. So that kind of attribute and that kind of criteria must be chosen. So here you can see the average less than 4.7 is the criteria chosen. And here number of images greater than or equal to 5.5 is chosen as the criteria. And here it is lesser than. Here it is greater than or equal to. So whether this is to be equality or inequality or multiple selection, that should also be decided, which you call a splitting criteria. Then how many number of splits you want, it depends on the domain of the attribute. So here, say for example, in this particular split I have binary split, because the domain values of this particular attribute is only two for my training data, which has only high and normal value. So I am having binary split. Whereas here for the outlook attribute, the domain is having three different values, so I am having multiple split, right? So if you have equality or inequality for the numerical values, then it will give you binary split. Whereas for the categorical values, if you have more number of values in the domain, then the multiple selection or multiple split will come from that particular attribute. So I can say number of splits depends on the domain of the attribute values. So if the domain value is having only two partition, then it goes for binary split. But whereas if it is having three or more values, then it goes for the multiple splits. And another issue is whenever we are constructing the tree, a balanced tree with few levels is the desirable tree structure. So always we must go for balanced tree rather than unbalanced tree. So only the balanced tree will give you the best classification rules. And another issue is, what should be the stopping criteria? The creation of the tree stops when the training data is perfectly classified. So stopping earlier can prevent the overfitting and generation of large tree, because you prefer always a simpler tree structure. And you can get simpler tree structure if you are going to have a proper stopping criteria, and if you can stop it earlier, right? Instead of having a larger tree, if you generate larger tree, obviously it is going to give you overfit problem. So to prevent the overfit problem, you can construct a simpler tree structure. And the training data is also another issue that you have to take care. Training data set can give rise to overfitting problem. Therefore, you must have valid data in the training data set without any noise, without have missing the values. Then pruning, you can have pre-pruning or post-pruning. Pre-pruning will halt the tree construction at the early stage, but post-pruning is better. It removes branches from the fully grown tree, and we know that pruning removes subtrees to achieve better performance, right? So these are the issues that will be faced while constructing the decision tree. So the summary of this particular video, we have seen how to construct the decision tree. By the time we have discussed the three different phases of decision tree construction, and we have seen what is pruning and what do you mean by overfitting problem. Then we have seen what are the issues faced during the construction of decision tree, the splitting criteria, splitting attribute, the number of splits, the tree structure, the stopping criteria, and the training data and the pruning process, right? So we will be discussing how to select the best splitting attribute and how to select the best splitting criteria in our upcoming video. Thank you.